This is a very personal comment. Probably the thing I admire the most about Gloria, and the thing that I have followed with fascination and to some degree of joy, and sometimes a little bit of playfulness in my heart, is I think people who know you know that one of your greatest strengths is your courage. That they may describe it as that you shook things up or you said this thing that startled people. But it has always seemed to me that you were a truth teller who in the truth telling demonstrated courage. And I'm just wondering if you could talk a little bit about what it is that makes you able to take that leap.
The College of Nursing at Wayne State.
We're all going to go light a candle in front of that place, you know.
You think I'm kidding?
No, I don't.
When I went to Wayne, I grew up, like I said, in Detroit. I was protected in my community. It was a black community. I went to schools where the staff and the faculty were mixed races, but the student body was a black student body. So when I went to Wayne, that was like, good Lord, you know, here are all these people. They're all so smart. They're white. They gotta know more than I know, you know. I mean, that was just the way I felt. And I would sit there in class, and the classes were small in those days, and the faculty, and it was in any number of them, you know, it wasn't just a single one would say, they'd ask questions and they expect an answer. And I would just sit there, and finally they would say, now, Miss Richardson, you know the answer to that. Why don't you speak up? And they just kept pushing and pushing, and they created the monster. I mean, that's exactly what happened. You know, they said, you know it, I know you know it, speak up. Mm-hmm. And I just feel they were so strong in their beliefs about nursing, what nursing is, what it must be, how important the practice is. They're simply, if there was one thing that I wish that somehow we could grasp and transfer to our current professionals is this kind of socialization, this sense of who you are and how important you are and how obligated you are to the people who helped you to get where you are. If we could just do it, but we don't, I don't see it happening in the same way. Our schools are too big, you know, I know it's difficult to do that, but how do we transfer that sense of, you know, I've got to do this. I mean, I'm obligated mm-hmm. to be this.
Yeah, there's a commitment.
And if you can't speak up and say what it is that you believe, then somehow you are not representing the community very effectively.
Yeah, you've said that several times. You still have a link in your soul, I think, to always remembering that you were going to give back to your own community. That is that part of a story of your legacy?
I think in many ways, and I'm ashamed in a way of some of this, in many ways, I still see myself in my community. You know, like some people, I never really had a lot of aspiration about being upper class.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm still anchored in my community, even though it's dumb because I know I'm not. You know, it's like if I go now back to my community, they'll see me as an outsider like anybody else. You know, you don't walk in with your briefcase. And people say, oh, she's home, she's one of us. It doesn't happen like that. But I feel that way. I feel in my soul, mm-hmm. you know.
And you still do very deliberate things to give back.
Yes, I do.
I mean, that has always hit me as part of your legacy. Are there other pieces of your legacy that if this audience were open to hearing about it, you'd give them? I think you've given them some on your passion about nursing. I think there's a social justice story.
Well, yes, that's part of, but you, like, you know, like the example I gave you of the School of Nursing mm-hmm. being responsible for integrating the hospitals, pretty much patient beds. That is because we were taught that schools of nursing can be instruments mm-hmm. for social justice. That you had a responsibility. The dean, we have an African American museum in Detroit that was started by Charles Wright, who was a black OBGYN man. And Catherine Fable was one of his friends, and she literally encouraged him to follow that dream and create that. It took many, many years, decades as a matter of fact, to create that museum. But that I see that as part of her legacy.
You know, this is not on our list, but it mm-hmm. just hit me. There's a community of black nurse leaders that are very powerful in the United States, of which you are a charter member. Can you talk about how significant it is that that group takes good care of each other, feeds the mission, moves things forward?
Well, I think it's important, although some of the younger ones aren't doing what I would like for them.
I'm sure that's true.
I tend to believe that people, you help folks to develop, and then you need to move aside and give them the opportunity to continue and to develop others. You know, I don't see people remaining in place and hogging the spotlight. I mean, that annoys me a lot.
That's an important insight, though. Mm-hmm. I mean, if leaders only got that, they'd get a lot. By now, they figure.
But if I haven't, I still want people to understand that if they don't have the message, I think I love graduate education, all these string of degrees, but I maintain that the socialization and the grounding that I got in my undergraduate program is largely responsible for who I am today. Those role models, those mentors were significant in my life and significant in helping me to frame what I think nursing is.
Yeah, actually, much of your entire story is about very strong people who were willing to give their time to you. That's what mm-hmm. I hear. By now,
willing, and I didn't ask.
Yeah, that's what I mean. It was spontaneous yeah. gifts mm-hmm. given. How generosity looks.
See, she's the intellectual one.
But she humors me, and it works out nicely.